Welcome back on Dynamod. Today I want to propose you a video about
The unboxing review about the number 457 of the WEDAF that it's released in October 2020 by the Games Workshop. On the cover we can find this, that is the same imaging that we can find on the Codex Necron one that has been released in October together to the Codex of the Space Marines. So if you are interested, in the description you can find the playlist for both the Codex Necron and the Codex Space Marine. The Codex Space Marine has yet released all the news about the Codex Necron. Soon there will be released also the analysis about the rules inside here. I need this simple the time to make all the two codex analyzed. Anyway, I hope that you like such idea. And now, so we can start to see what are the contents inside this WEDAF. Here we have the theme of the WEDAF, here the alternative cover of the WEDAF itself, that we see later better. Here we have an introduction about the Flashpoint, that it's a sort of under campaign of the main campaign of the Paria Nexus. In this case there are a lot of views and a lot of things to remember about such, so I decided to not talk in detail about this even later, because there are really a lot of things. If you are interested about, I suggest you to buy such a WEDAF and go to read in detail this one, but also the next one, because it say that this specific Flashpoint it will last till the end of the year, so October, November and December, 3 months. And I think that can be quite interesting for the one, moreover, that are interested about campaigns and so on, because there are a lot of rules, a lot of way to play something completely new, I think. So it can be quite amazing. So I suggest you eventually to read, because otherwise I'd have to make a complete video only for such part, because there are a lot of information inside. Here there are the contents that are inside this WEDAF, and here the mailing list of the readers to the team of the WEDAF. And here we can find these, that are bindings done with the residual of the spruce from a girl that is 11 years old. So, seeing this, I had a thing in mind. Why not to create a sort of challenge so that we can use Instagram? You can find also in the description my Instagram, but it's at Dynamod. So that we can create something new with what it's useless. Okay, I usually use this remaining and so on for other things too, but I noticed that still had a tons of them. So why not use at least some of them or so on to create something new, and so create our own building and share together? So I think to use the hashtag scratching building, and so using this to create something peculiar. I think that it can be quite interesting, and we can so use something that it can be said as useless and make something like it's useful. I think that it's quite good. And then we can see the modification, painting schemes and so on, some suggestions that we can find about such, for example, such bases that can be interesting, or some little modification, some scheme of colors. There are a lot of things, for example, this base, that it's a simple change of the base of such model that can be interesting. Also this one, such scheme of colors, this type of bases, this one. There can be a lot of little things inside that can be quite interesting. Even this, for example, such little modification, little things, or scheme of colors, because we can be interested, for example, in such type like this, can be, I think, a bit of inspiration. For example, I don't like at all this type of base, because I really don't like it. Too simple and mixed without not good. But it's my opinion. Your one can be the same, or from the rear can be even better. Then we can find this, that it's a novel related about the Black Rabbi. And I want to remind you that the Black Rabbi is selecting some authors about new horrors writing, so eventually you can go to see the site of the Black Library and try to see if they publish your own opera. And so we have an entire opera of this author. I think that it can be quite interesting if you like this type of reading, but anyway it's a good way. Then we have this, that it's an article about John Dan Green, about how it's the concept behind the background of Warhammer Warhammer 40k, Age of Sigmar, Warhammer, and everything else that can be keep your attention on. And if you want, it's a way also to justify such writing. So how you can write something similar? I think that can be quite amazing. The images are always amazing. And then we can go to see a bit about Age of Sigmar with a new Tom Celeste related about the Trolls, with the Trogger Gods of the Realms. And I want to remember you about this, that has been released a FAQ that allows you to use such ones, because there has been problems previously about such release. Now you can use. There is a lot of background, really. If you are interested about this, you can find a lot of things related about that can be quite interesting, and really a lot of ways to play with this one after reading this. And here we talk about playing, we have about playing. So it can be quite good, this one. So here we have also a showcase army about such troll type of armies. And we can find that we can gain a lot of suggestion, inspiration about painting schemes, for example. The basis, probably not, but think about these shiny elements and so on. This can be quite inspirational. So I think that can be quite good. And here an article about Javis Johnson about how to create your own, try to calculate the points and how difficult it is. And if you find something similar about this, it's because there is this one, the Jan Hempel 2020, with the Anvils of Apotheosis to create your own character. This one is quite similar, so it can be really a sort of base that you can use. You can try eventually to use the same and so on. And you can apply also to other games eventually to create your own character or your own unit eventually. So I suggest you to read eventually, because I think that can have quite a lot of interesting ideas that you can gain from. Then have this, that it's an interview of a winner of 2 Demon Slayers. And so we can find about its operas, the first Demon Slayer that it's been done in the 2010. And here this one that has been done last year, because this year there has not been one about. So it's about the 2019. And something that it's even more interesting, because here we can see how it has been painted, the details. But here, how it has been built, how it has been modified, created, and so on. So I think that this can be quite interesting to see how, with something that it's, I can say static but basic, we can then create a contour around that improve the way that we can find this. And obviously there is the paint that it's also. Then we can move on Warhammer 40k with this wonderful image, really amazing. And then we can go to see this part, that it's about the campaign that we talked before about the Flashpoint, in this case about the Argovon campaign. This is really quite rich of things, really. There is a lot of things to read, a lot of things to analyze. So it's not something that I can synthesize quite fast, because there are the background and also the rules, and will be a lot of ways. So I think that this can be really quite an amazing one to try. If you're interested about campaigns, I think that this can be quite inspirational. Maybe not something that you want to play with, but something that you want to use as a model to play with. And if we have seen about the background, we have seen about the rules, here a tale about what is happening during this Flashpoint. So it's something that I suggest you to read, because it's quite interesting. And then here the Forge Worlds, that it's the classic world zones, so how you can personalize your models based on the environment that they are fighting in, that they are living in. And so we can find the painting scheme of colors, the different bases, the reasoning. For example, this model that you can see here, it's the base of a model from the Nighthaunt, that it's the Kurdos Valerian, that it's the Roman King. And so it's, you can see that from the original model with little modifying, we can gain something that it's completely different and completely amazing, quite awesome. Also here, the base that it's modified, there are a lot of things that we can find as suggestion about inspiration. Here, for example, another option about the painting. Here, this one, for example, I'll bring you a modifying about this in the future, because I have some ideas about such models that I have. And then we can find that we have this one, that it's an article about Elliot Wormer, and it's about, we can say that, I can say how to go to play, not to be, I can say, concentrated and blind only to one type of playing, so not only the match, not only the narrative and so on. Give a try to different ways, even in the same match, you can find different ways to create your army, to personalize and so on, and this can expand your horizons. I completely agree with this article in this case, because I think that it's quite interesting. This image is simply amazing. And then we have a bit about that describes, so in this case, how it works the game, so a presentation, I can say, about the game itself, and so how it works and so on. Then we have a fiction about Biscrave, so a bit of narrative, it's always welcome. There is a lot of narrative in this Wild Earth. And then we have the part about the tactics for Biscrave. In this case, I leave this as the part about the analysis of the rules to the ones that I'm interested about, because I don't like to play this game, but it's a good game, simply I'm not interested about. But the images are quite interesting, and if you are interested about this, can be quite useful. The miniatures, anyway, I like a lot. As you can see, there are a lot of things. And then we have something that can be interesting for everyone, even if this image, you can think that it's a film that you are not interested about, because it's a photography, you want to play, you want to paint, but see how from this you can gain this, so how you can make improve the aspect of your miniatures, having an amazing battlefield sight. So I think that can be quite useful to understand how it works, how you can gain such images that are amazing. So go to see this one if you're interested to have some photos that are amazing, and evaluate and make really your miniatures gain even more life. I think that it's quite interesting, it's really quite good, because we can find that these are models, but they seem almost like, I can say, almost a cinematic, really quite amazing one of real models in a fantasy environment, really quite nice. See this effect, it's amazing. This is almost like painted, and it's a real model. Okay, it's a model that is painted, but it's really quite amazing. And then we have something that someone can be missed, because there is the return about the Blackstone Fortress. So new rules about this. So for the ones that want to play this, there are new rules, new way to play, and it's always welcome, this one. And then we have something about the Middle Earth. I don't play this game, so I leave to you this one. But the image and so on can be interesting. I think that the minutes about Middle Earth and the Lord of the Ring in general can be quite good to make conversions on. I see for that. And then a part about the campaign for the Necromunda, that can be quite interesting for the ones that like to play such a game. Because I think that can be quite good to give a sight about. And then another part about the Faith and Fire, that I want to remind you, there are different parts in every Wild Earth, and so there will be all the book about Faith and Fire. So for the ones that are interested, I think that this is a good way to give a try, as I usually say, about the Black Library writing, so that it's quite good to understand if you are interested about buying other books of the Black Library. Obviously, every author has a different style and so on, and you can appreciate more or less. I have also my favorite in the Black Library writing. But still, it's something that I think that it's good to understand how it's the quality, and so try to read about. And then have these that are the parts that will be released in the next videos of the next Wild Earth and so on. And so have a sort of anticipation about, I think that can be quite interesting. And here we can see something that we'll analyze later. But here we can find the alternative cover of this Wild Earth. Since the I prefer the other one, but I have yet it on the Codex of the Necron. So this one, I think that it's better because it's a bit classical one, but at the same time, I think that it's a unique one. So I prefer a bit more because this. And so we have now this one that it's the final one, and are the Tomekeepers that is the part that we see in other previous White Dwarf, and has been the creation about the background, the icons, and everything about such chapter. And so in the next White Dwarf we see the rules to play them. I think that can be quite interesting about this, because we can see that we have seen a birth of a new chapter of Space Marine related about the White Dwarf, but it can be quite interesting. So what to say about such White Dwarf? I think that it's really quite amazing. There are a lot of things that you can use as a referring about modifying, painting, eventually a lot about narrative, because we have a lot of fiction, a lot of background and so on to read about, and so it's really quite an inspirational one. And I want to remember you about again that my idea about having this challenge to use our sprues for giving birth again, okay, but to new shining elements and share it together. So eventually send me about such photos, tagging me in your creation with the hashtag sketching building. Anyway,
from Dynamod it's everything. I invite you to put a like on this video, to subscribe to the channel, to ring the bell, and to comment this video if you are interested in something about this video, or you want to suggest me some arguments for other videos. I hope to see you again to the next time.